So hello students, this is exercise 6.2, question number 6. This is the last exercise in exercise 6.2 and we are seeing the class for 9th standard for CBSE student. You are given two mirrors placed in parallel position. You take the two mirrors, you keep in parallel position. Parallel position means the distance between the parallels, the distance between the parallels are equal. Parallel, we are keeping the mirror PQ and the mirror RS in parallel position. And you are given the incident ray. AB is the incident ray which strikes the mirror PQ at B. So AB is the incident ray. So definitely BC will be the reflected ray. AB is the incident ray and BC is the reflected ray. This reflected ray becomes incident ray when it strikes at the point C, the mirror RS. So when it strikes the mirror RS at the point C, it becomes the incident ray. So normally again it is reflect and it moves along the path CD. So AB is the incident ray and then BC is the reflected ray. This reflected ray becomes the incident ray when it touches at C. And again reflects back, which moves along the path CD. And you know the property, angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. This is by law of reflection. Now we draw perpendiculars BL and CM. So first step, this only it is given. We want to prove AB parallel to CD. This AB, this incident ray parallel to the reflected ray CD. That only we want to prove. So we have to prove AB parallel to CD. So we just strike out this. So three properties we are using in this question. One is angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. Another one, interior alternate angles are equal. Then another one, perpendiculars to the parallel lines are parallel. Here parallel. They are parallel to each other. So first one, draw BL and CM. Draw the perpendiculars. Draw BL perpendicular to which one? PQ and CM perpendicular to RS. So usually perpendiculars to the parallel lines are parallel. This is the result we know. Are parallel. So perpendiculars to the parallel lines are parallel. They are parallel to each other. This property we know. So this is the first one. So when they are parallel, that is here which one? BL parallel to CM. So according to this property we know BL, this BL parallel to CM. This is parallel to CM. And which is the transversal? BC is the transversal. This is the transversal. And if you know parallel lines and transversal means interior alternate angles are equal. So by property interior alternate angles are equal. Since they are parallel and transversal line we are getting, therefore interior alternate angles are equal. Which is the, this one, BL and MC. This is the transversal. So since it is a transversal, this interior alternate angles are equal. That is L, B, C equal to which one? This angle equal to this angle. BCM, BCM. So LBC equal to BCM. So this is first property we know. Then again we know by law of reflection. By law of reflection, angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. So angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. So this property we know. Then which is angle of, this is I, this is I, this is R. This is angle of incidence. Here this is I and this is R. So angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence A, B, L equal to angle of reflection L, B, C. And that side here, angle of reflection B, C, M. And B, C, M equal to angle of reflection M, C, D. It's clear. This is angle of incidence, angle of reflection, angle of incidence, angle of reflection, and they are equal. Here it is given LBC equal to BCM. So since they are equal, you can just cancel this. This angle you do, you can cancel this. And add the remaining. So we can add LHS and RHS. This side you add LHS. So LBC or you rate ABL plus LBC equal to RHS side BCM, BCM plus MCD. So you are adding equals or added to equals. By the property equals or added to equals, you are adding LHS side and RHS side. So if you add ABL plus LBC, you are getting totally ABC. Then in RHS side, BCM. Which is BCM? This BCM. Then MCD. MCD. When it is added together, you are getting BCD. So now you see, here this is AB. And this is CD, and this is the transversal. We have come to the conclusion ABC, this ABC is equal to BCD. So since alternate angles are equal, by converse, you can write by converse, definitely AB parallel to CD. This is the sum we want to do. Since the alternate angles are equal, by converse, here it is given, if parallel means we can use interior alternate angles are equal. Here it is, we have proved interior alternate angles are equal. Definitely by the converse you can prove AB parallel to CD. That's